Hi folks. Well, after that last video entitled Talents, Observations, and Abilities, I'd like to do a follow-up to that video and talk about the arm of the Lord. Now, is there a relationship between that last video and what we spoke of in there and the arm of the Lord, or the right hand of the Lord, or the left hand of the Lord? And the answer is yes, there's a very, very huge relationship. Let me read this to you. It's found in Psalm 74, verse 11. And it says, why do you hold back your hand, your right hand? Speaking of the Lord's right hand, why does the Lord hold it back? Take it from the folds of your garment and destroy them. It's interesting to think that it is the right hand of God that is the most powerful. Well, if you look at a huge segment of society, most people are right-handed. Yeah, there are left-handed folks as well, and there are ambidextrous, use of both hands as the dominant as well. But for the majority, the right hand is the first, the leader, the authority. The left helps the right. You know, my father-in-law, he beat his son because his son wanted to use his left hand, wanted to write with his left hand when he was small. And you think, man, that seems crazy, you know. But old world, and a very predominant belief that from the left, something bad comes forth, whereas from the right, good comes forth. Everyone else uses their right hand. Here's my son using his left. No, I don't want that. Anyways, his actions forced his son to use his right hand, although he is left-handed. So he's ambidextrous. He's just as competent with both hands. Interesting thing about old world superstitions, they do come from a valid source, but they get twisted. And the idea of the right hand being the hand of God and the left hand being of the devil is the twist. That's not correct. But it started somewhere. Did it start with something proper? Yeah, it did. But over time, things get messed up. If we think of logic and emotion, if we think of truth and love, if we think image and likeness, these things I spoke of in that last video, is there a relationship between these things and the right and left hand? And the answer is yes, most definitely. As I read to you here in Psalms, it is from the right hand that God can destroy. And if we think of truth, yeah, it's truth that is sharp like a double-edged sword and can destroy. Truth can give life, truth can take life away. Love, on the other hand, no. Love is supposed to accompany truth. My right hand, truth. My left hand, love. Love is supposed to accompany truth to help. There are a myriad of scriptures that we could bring forth. The video would be too long and no one would appreciate it, I'm sure, but If you take the time, if you have a concordance, or if you have an electronic Bible, or if you have the computer, then the internet, just type in, go to a Bible that you like, and type in right hand and right arm, and start reading. And then type in the word left, left hand, left arm, and you'll learn something. You'll learn something. In the presence of God, yes, Satan stands on God's left. So when you're reading about this in Zechariah, I'll put it on the screen. When you're reading about this, remember you're looking at it from God's perspective. So put yourself in the place of God, because my right hand is here. But to you, that's my left. it's your left, really. You understand what I mean? Look at it from the perspective, from what it's written. Don't. You have to be careful when you're reading Scripture. Scripture is very, very precise. And you have to stay on, right on that razor's edge, in order to discover the mysteries. And yeah, the devil is on God's left hand. The devil is not God's left hand, however. The devil has been cast away. But where did the devil go to entice, to destroy God's creation? Well, he went to the left of Adam, didn't he? Didn't he go to Eve? Didn't I tell you Eve represents emotion, where we find love or hate? So the devil had a purpose in trying to deceive Eve first, so they could get to Adam. Truth and love. Logic and emotion. Truth and love. Logic and emotion. Adam, Eve. The masculine, the authority, the right, the feminine, the submissive, the left. And this is what it's talking about. When we think of the hand of God, and then we read about the arm of God, isn't the arm not that which to which the hand is connected? Can a hand work without an arm? Well, the answer is no. So when we think of the arm of God, we're thinking of the Christ, truth and love in flesh. But when we're thinking the hand of God, let's see if I can find it here. I bookmarked some of these. Where do I find bookmarks? List, bookmark list, there we are. Let me just run down these. I'm thinking there. It says in Psalms 45 verse 4, in your majesty, speaking of the Lord, in your majesty ride forth victoriously in behalf of truth, humility, and righteousness. Let your right hand display awesome deeds. What are these awesome deeds? Truth, humility, and righteousness. The right hand of God. Stands to reason then, what's the left? Well, it's love. It's love, it's the likeness. It's the it's emotion. Maybe I can. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I'm just. These are the facts. Do you want a full blown Bible study of how I come to these conclusions? Well, list. Let's go back to the list. Roman. Yeah, let's try that one. Psalms 44 and 3. It was not by their sword that they won the land, nor did their arm bring them victory. No, it was your arm, your right hand, and the light of your face, O Lord, for you love them. You are my King and my God, who decrees victories for Jacob. Important. Men think that they win or they succeed in life by their own power, and they don't. They don't. They think they do. In their absence of knowing and understanding God, truth and love, and the devil, falsehood and hatred, they think they're something when they're nothing. It's no wonder the Apostle Paul called us worms. He's right. We're not what we think we are. It is not by their sword that they won the land, nor did their arm bring them victory. It was your right hand, your arm, and the light of your face, O Lord, for you loved them. So the right hand is, we find the righteousness. The arm, that to which righteousness is connected, it is the body of Christ, it is Christ Jesus, and the face of God Himself, again, it is Jesus, the Messiah, truth and love in flesh. Anyways, I hope that causes a little bit of provokes a little thought about the right and the left. Paul said something, I don't know exactly where now. It wasn't Paul. I think it was Jesus that said it. Don't let your right hand know what your left hand is doing. Interesting concept, eh? Interesting concept. Sometimes we have to, how did I say that? Don't let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, I think is the way it goes. I'll have to read it and find it. It's an interesting concept. Sometimes we have to be very careful in doing the righteous thing, not to let our conscience and the idea of, well, is that love? And, well, yeah, it is for this one, it's not for that one. And you know what I mean? We have to be conscious of keeping Eve under control, remember? Keeping emotion under control and fighting with truth. Fighting with truth. Be careful. Anyways, I think that's enough said. Leave a comment if it is enough or it isn't enough, or what questions it prompts you to ask. It is a very interesting subject. Very interesting. And more could be said. So, God bless you all. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Bye for now.